Hello again, everyone. My name is Mario Tiozzo, and I'm the Data Analysis and Visualization Librarian here at UMB Libraries. Today, we are going to take a look at how to analyze the data in this spreadsheet and visualize it with a scatterplot chart. Here, we have the cumulative production percentage of daily widget quota in a factory. The data is taken at hourly intervals and over 14 consecutive days. Once again, let's start with getting some statistical information from our data, and then we will build on that. First, we want to calculate the percentage averages. We will do this by using the average function of Excel. Now, we've done this before in previous labs, so I will go a little bit faster this time. First, I'll tag it, mean, and then I will put the equal sign. Average is the name of the function that we want. The 9 o'clock time slot data that we want is right there. Close out the parentheses and we press enter. Then we can go back to that cell, go to the bottom right corner, left click and drag all the way to the last entry. And we have the averages for all our time slots now. Next, we will do the same for standard deviation equals STD, STDEV.S is there for sample, which is what we want. We can press tab to autocomplete. Again, select the data that we want, close out the parentheses, press enter, go back to the cell, go bottom right corner, left click and drag all the way to the end. Great. Do the same thing for number of observations. In this case, we use a count function. And we repeat the process. 14. Seems right because there's 14 days and they're all the same throughout, so they should be 14 throughout. Great. Finally, we have the standard error, which, as you recall, is the standard deviation over the square root of the number of observations. So we select the standard deviation, which is in B18, divided by the square root, which is SQRT, open parentheses, of the number of observations, which is in B19, and we close out the parentheses. We click and drag to get our standard error for all the time slots. Okay, we have all the statistical information we need to construct our chart. So let's build one. And this time we will pick the scatterplot chart. First, we select our variables, time and average percentage of completion, both of which are continuous values. Remember, I use a control button to select both lines. We then click on the Insert tab and click on the scatterplot chart, and we'll pick the first iteration here. Now let's try to clean it up a little bit and make it more meaningful. First, let's add elements that we want to include. Bring this up a little bit.
As a reminder, you can add or remove chart elements by clicking on the chart and either pressing on the plus sign or pressing on the Chart Design tab and then the Add Chart Element button in the ribbon. This time, I will
press the plus sign and we'll add the error bars that we want. You'll notice that there's horizontal and vertical error bars. In this case, we just want the vertical, so we'll select a horizontal one, and it'll select all the horizontal ones. We'll just press Delete. Great. Just like before, we have to do a little bit of work. We go to Custom, Specify Value, delete the values in Positive Error Value, and we'll put in our own value here, which we've calculated for Standard Error. And we'll repeat the process, delete, enter for the negative error values, and we'll press OK. Great, now we have our error bars. Now we'll add axis titles. We'll do the same, we'll go back to the chart, click on it, the plus sign, and add the axis titles. And we will populate them. In this case, I will write cumulative quota completion and the units percentage. And then x-axis, I will write time in hours. I just noticed that I misspelled quota. So let's go back here. And perfect. Now you'll notice that the data is all squished on the right side of the chart. Let's modify the x-axis to make that a little bit more presentable. So we click on the axis, and then we can see that the format axis box shows up on the right-hand side. If it did not show up, you could always right-click and go to format axis here, which will also bring up the table. Now you likely won't have to go through this in your assignment, but I thought I would explain how hours work in Excel. Excel treats hours as numbers. So 1 hour is 1/24. For ease of purpose, let's do an example here. If we do equals 1 divided by 24, which was 1/24, we get this result. So 1 hour is 0.04 of a day. So if we wanted to get 9 hours, because our start is 9 hours, 9 o'clock, it would be this value, so equals this value times 9. That would be our starting point. And our ending point would be 1 hour times 17. So if we click back on, right click, format axis, we could put our minimum here. That's 0.375, 9 o'clock, perfect. And our end time would be 0.7083333. And you'll notice that we don't get to 5 o'clock, and that's because our units are not hourly. We can see that our jumps are not from hour to hour. It's not from 9 to 10 to 11. It doesn't get to 5 o'clock. So we have to change our units as well to an hour. So an hour, as we know, is 4166666. And now we have our 9 to 5 timestamps in our chart. Like I said, this is probably not something that you're going to have to do in your assignment, but I thought that I would just give you some background on it in case you come across it in later stages of your academic career. And the takeaway here is that you can modify both the y-axis or the x-axis. The last element that we're going to want to add is the trend line. So we go back to the plus sign here, and we'll notice that there's a trend line. And when we click on it, we get a nice linear trend line. We can click on the expandable button here and go to more options. And we can click on the display equation on chart right here. And an equation will pop up automatically. Now this is the equation of the trend line. So we can test this. So we know that at 17 o'clock, we have 100% completion on average. So if we test this, and we know that 0.7083333 is the same as 17 o'clock for in Excel purposes, you can do that times 2.9571, I'm just taking this from the formula, minus 1.0927, and it gives us a weird number, but if we change that into a percentage, it's 100%. And if we expand that a little bit, it's 11.19%, and our actual is 11.36%, which means that our average, or actual average, is slightly above the trend line. So this is an important segue to note that the trend line is not the same thing as a line chart. The trend line is a line of best fit, which means it tries to go through all the data and minimize the distance between it and the data set. Whereas a line chart connects all the data points together. If we zoom in, we can see that there are certain data points that are clearly either above or below the trend line. So this is not a line chart. Okay, now that we've added our elements, let's clean this up a bit and remove any superfluous elements. We can get rid of both grid lines by clicking on them one at a time, pressing delete, and pressing delete again. We can remove the border by going no line on the border, and we can delete the chart title. Great, now let's add our figure caption. So let's clean this up a bit. We can delete this stuff, and we can add our caption. Again, we'll try to match the footprint by pressing merge and center, and then pressing wrap text. Then we'll go to left justify, and we will bold figure one. There, that looks good. We can create a white background. Pressing here. Use our snipping tool. It's important to remove your cursor from the snipping area, or else you'll have it in your snipping area. Let's try that again. Great. Now we have a nice clean chart and caption that we can paste into our Word document or PowerPoint presentation. I hope that this was helpful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video. Bye for now.